purpose of component diagram. So here we are having some text to discuss with some diagrams to indicate what are the purposes of a component diagram in UML. Component diagram is a special kind of diagram in UML. The purpose is also different from all other diagrams discussed so far, which are there in the UML, and it does not describe the functionality of the system, but it describes the components used to make those functionalities. That means regarding the functionalities, component diagram is not meant for that. But what are the different components that will be used to implement those functionalities that will be described in the component diagram? Thus, from that point of view, component diagrams are used to visualize the physical components in a system. These components are libraries, packages, files, DLLs. It might be executable programs. Some applications might be also. It might be something like your different libraries. It has been mentioned here. So all these things, it might be the ActiveX. It might be some, say, applets. So these are known as the components which will be used in our component diagram for the visualization. So component diagrams can also be described as a static implementation view of a system. So it is not corresponding to the dynamic characteristics of the system. It is a static view of the system. And static implementation represents the organization of the components at a particular moment of time. How these components are related, who is accessing whom. So all these things will be depicted in this component diagram. A single component diagram cannot represent the entire system when the system will be real life system. In that case, a single component diagram may not depict the full system. So in that case, the component diagram will be such a huge one. So it will be quite difficult to comprehend and understand. So that's why, but a collection of diagrams is used to represent the whole. So let us go for some more detailing on it. The purpose of the component diagram can be summarized as visualize the components of a system. That means it will have some diagrams, some diagrammatic notations are there with the help of which we can visualize what are the components we are going to use. Construct executables by using forward and reverse engineering. So we are going to use or we're going to construct some executable programs and describe the organization and relationships of those components. So here we are having the generic component. So whenever you are talking about the component, the diagram would look like this. This is a subprogram specification. That means here only the prototypes will be mentioned, only the specifications will be mentioned, not the subprogram bodies. So for the subprogram body, we are having a different notation there. And here we are having the main program. So where this particular components will be accessed, will be called or will be accessed from here. And there is a subprogram specification. This is a subprogram body. So here only the prototypes will be written. Just consider, say, our, say, different header files which you use. You know that header files are nothing but text files. You can easily open this one in any text editor. And there you can find multiple different prototypes of different methods. And library files are containing those method bodies. So that's why we are having the similarity here also. So here we are having the only the prototype declarations. Here we might be having the respective function bodies. So in this way, these are the component diagrams symbols which will be used for making the component diagram of one executable application. Please watch next videos to know more on this component diagram. Thanks for watching this.